The Prime Minister has accused critics of the Voice to Parliament of trying to start a culture war. Anthony Albanese used a major speech today to urge Australians to drown out the misinformation and instead focus on the referendum as a historic step for the country.
The Prime Minister is determined to defend democracy.
It needs to be nourished, protected, cared for, treated with respect.
Drawing parallels between misinformation overseas.
These explosions of bull
and criticism of the Voice to Parliament here at home.
Drumming up outrage, trying to start a culture war.
Using a major speech ahead of the first parliamentary sitting of the year to make his case for the referendum.
It will be a great democratic moment and a great Australian moment.
His comments not going down too well with the opposition.
He's made this issue into a political one by talking about culture wars.
The Shadow Indigenous Affairs Minister has supported a Voice to Parliament for nearly a decade. Julian Lisa defending the 15 questions put to the Prime Minister by Peter Dutton as reasonable.
But we've got to a point here where the Prime Minister has set the date. The Prime Minister has said we're having a referendum this year. It's for the Prime Minister to provide detail.
But they won't all be answered.
Some of the questions will be answered and some can't be.
While others will need to be addressed by First Nations people contributing to the model of the Voice.
Most Australians would find that logical and fair.
Anthony Albanese holds that same optimism.
The Uluru statement from the heart is a hand outstretched. This year, let us all vote to grasp it.
When Parliament returns tomorrow, don't expect a formal position on the Voice from the Liberals. The Greens, however, they're getting closer and are expected to announce their support after the party room meets on Tuesday, with just one holdout, and that's Senator Lydia Thorpe.
I think everyone should get on board with the Voice.
Stella Todorovic for 10 News First.